गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अवर टॉपिक इज इंग्वाइनल कैनाल. सो इंग्वाइनल कैनाल, व्हाट इज इंग्वाइनल कैनाल? इंग्वाइनल कैनाल इज एन ओब्लिक इंटरमस्कुलर पैसेज और कैनाल ऑन द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ एंटीरियर एब्डोमिनल वॉल. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इंग्वाइनल कैनाल. इट इज एन ओब्लिक पैसेज और कैनाल ऑन द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ एंटीरियर एब्डोमिनल वॉल जस्ट अबव द medial half of inguinal ligament. As you can appreciate here, this is the inguinal ligament which extend for anterior spiliac spine to pubic tubercle. So this is inguinal ligament. So inguinal canal is just above its medial half of inguinal ligament. So this is the location of inguinal canal. Now it extends. So inguinal canal is 4 cm in length and it extends from deep inguinal ring to superficial inguinal ring. As you can see here, this gap in the epidermis of external oblique muscle here, this triangular gap is superficial inguinal ring. This triangular gap here is superficial inguinal ring. So deep inguinal ring is basically deep structure, deep end of inguinal canal. So location of deep inguinal ring is, it is 1.2 centimeter above the mid inguinal point. So here should be the mid inguinal point. So it is 1.2 centimeter above the mid inguinal point. So here somewhere is the location of deep inguinal ring. I will show you deep inguinal ring later. So this was superficial inguinal ring. Superficial inguinal ring is the triangular gap or opening on the lower part of external oblique aponeurosis and it is anterior superior to pubic tubercle. Superior lateral to pubic tubercle, not anterior superior, it is superior lateral to pubic tubercle. So what are the boundaries of this superficial inguinal ring? It is triangular gap or triangular ring or opening. The base of this opening is formed by pubic crest. Base of superficial inguinal ring is formed by pubic crest. It has two other boundaries. These are called crura. This is medial crest and this is lateral crest. Medial crest is also called upper boundary, or lateral crest is also called lower boundary. So these crura unite at the apex and they are united by the intercrural fibers. What are intercrural fibers? These are the extensions of inguinal ligament. Intercrural fibers are the extensions of inguinal ligament. We have 4 extensions of inguinal ligament. So intercrural fibers are the one of the extension of inguinal ligament. So this is all about superficial inguinal ring. Now, as you know, superficial inguinal ring, from superficial inguinal ring there exit the content of inguinal canal. So this is the spermatic cord. So in male, spermatic cord is the content of inguinal canal, or it is emerging or exiting from this superficial inguinal ring. This is spermatic cord. As this is male body, the spermatic cord is the content of inguinal canal. In female, round ligament is the content of inguinal canal. So this is spermatic cord. Along the spermatic cord, there is a nerve. This nerve is also exiting from superficial inguinal ring. This is called ilioinguinal nerve. So ilioinguinal nerve and spermatic cord, both are the content of inguinal canal and they are exiting from superficial inguinal ring. Now this was the distal end of inguinal canal. It was superficial inguinal ring. So now talking about the boundaries of inguinal canal. So inguinal canal is bounded by 4 sides, or it has 4 walls. It has anterior wall, it has posterior wall, it has roof and floor. एंटीरियर वॉल, पोस्टीरियर वॉल, रूफ एंड फ्लोर. सो एज यू कैन सी दिस इज़ द एंटीरियर वॉल ऑफ इंग्वाइनल कैनाल. एज इट इज़ ओनली 4 सेंटीमीटर इन लेंथ एंड इट इज़ अबव द मीडियल हाफ ऑफ इंग्वाइनल लिगामेंट. सो एंटीरियर वॉल ऑफ इंग्वाइनल कैनाल इज़ फॉर्म्ड बाय स्किन इन इट्स होल एक्सटेंट. इट इज़ फॉर्म्ड बाय स्किन, सुपरफिशियल फेशिया. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिमूव दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स. सो यू कैन सी दिस पार्ट, दिस स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज एपोनरोसिस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक मसल. सो एंटीरियर वॉल इन इट्स होल एक्सटेंट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय स्किन, सुपरफिशियल फेशिया एंड एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एपोनरोसिस. दिस इज एपोनरोसिस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक मसल. सो एज वी रिफ्लेक्ट दिस एपोनरोसिस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक मसल, नाउ यू कैन सी दी डीप स्ट्रक्चर्स. दीज आर दी फाइबर्स ऑफ इंटरनल ओब्लिक मसल. एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दे आर 3 flat muscles. आउटर वन इज एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक, देन इंटरनल ओब्लिक, डीप टू दिस इज ट्रांसवर्सस एबडोमिनिस. सो दीज आर दी फाइबर्स ऑफ इंटरनल ओब्लिक मसल. सो एंटीरियर वॉल इज ऑल्सो फॉर्म्ड बाय दीज फाइबर्स ऑफ इंटरनल ओब्लिक मसल. सो इन इट्स होल एक्सटेंट एंटीरियर वॉल ऑफ इंग्वाइनल कैनाल इज फॉर्म्ड बाय स्किन, सुपरफिशियल फेशिया एंड एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एपोनरोसिस. इन एडिशन लेटरल 1/3 पार्ट ऑफ दिस कैनाल इज ऑल्सो फॉर्म्ड बाय fleshy fibers of internal oblique muscle. These are also formed by fleshy fibers of internal oblique muscles. So these are the fibers taking origin from the inguinal ligament. So these are the fleshy fiber. They are also forming the lateral part or lateral 1/3 part of inguinal canal, anterior wall of inguinal canal. So this is all about anterior wall. Now as you can see these fibers are arching over the contents of inguinal canal. As you know these are the contents of inguinal canal. This is spermatic cord, as this is male body. So these fibers of internal oblique muscle also arching over the contents of inguinal canal and forming its roof. So the roof of inguinal canal is formed by these arched fibers, these curvy fibers. As you can see here, these are curvy fibers and these are called arched fiber. So the roof of inguinal canal is formed by the arched fiber of internal oblique muscle and also transverse abdominis muscle, because transverse abdominis muscle is deep to internal oblique. So deep to this we have transversus abdominis muscle. So both together will form the roof of inguinal canal and they join together, the aponeurosis of both the muscles join together and run medially and will form a common tendon. This tendon is called conjoint tendon. This is formed by the aponeurosis of internal oblique and transversus abdominis muscle. This is called conjoint tendon. Conjoint tendon inserts on the medial part of pectin pubis and pubic crest. Medial part of pectin pubis and pubic crest. So this is all about roof and these are arched fiber of internal oblique and transverse abdominis. They will form roof first and will join together, will form a conjoint tendon medially. So roof is formed by internal oblique and transverse abdominis muscle. If we reflect these two along with conjoint tendon, you will see the contents of inguinal canal. This whole passage is inguinal canal. This is spermatic cord and this is male body. And if I reflect this content anteriorly, you can see the posterior wall of inguinal canal. This is the posterior wall of inguinal canal. So this posterior wall in its whole extent is formed by fascia transversalis, In addition, the medial half of this posterior wall is also formed by this conjoint tendon. And the medial end of posterior wall is formed by the reflected part of inguinal ligament. Reflected part of inguinal ligament is its one of the extension. Now talking about the roof. If you reflect the spermatic cord upwards, this is the floor. Talking about floor, this is the floor of inguinal canal. The floor of inguinal canal is formed by the curved superior or the grooved superior surface of inguinal ligament. This is forming the floor of inguinal canal. And most medially, it is also formed by lacunar ligament. Lacunar ligament is also one of the extension of inguinal ligament. So lacunar ligament is forming the middle part of floor. So this is the floor of inguinal canal. So this is all about the boundaries of inguinal canal. Anterior wall is formed by external oblique aponeurosis in its whole extent, and also fleshy fiber of internal oblique in its lateral one-third part. Then roof is formed by internal oblique, transversus abdominis. These are arched fibers. And posterior wall is formed by fascia transversalis, and also medial half is formed by conjoint tendon. This is conjoint tendon here. Now talking about the contents of inguinal canal. As I already told you, in male it is spermatic cord and ilioinguinal nerve. In female it is round ligament and ilioinguinal nerve. So this is spermatic cord. Now this side, see, we have dissected this spermatic cord. Now what are the contents of spermatic cord? Just have a look. The main content is ductus deferens. If we dissect spermatic cord or take a transverse section, you can see this is the ductus deferens, and we have plexus of veins coming from testis. We have tympaniform plexus of veins. In between these plexus, we have testicular artery. So this is a combined set of testicular veins which is forming a plexus, tympaniform plexus along with testicular artery. Then we also have a very, very important nerve. This nerve is called genitofemoral nerve. So these are some important contents of spermatic cord. So this is all about the inguinal canal. We have discussed it extends from deep inguinal canal. So I have told you deep inguinal canal. This is deep inguinal ring. Here this is fascia transversalis, and here somewhere there is an oval opening on the fascia transversalis where the spermatic cord is coming, or the round ligament infimole is coming. This oval opening is called deep inguinal ring. This is 1.2 centimeter above the mid inguinal point. This is 1.2 centimeter above the mid inguinal point. So this is all about deep inguinal up to superficial inguinal ring. We have two ends of inguinal canal. Then we have anterior wall. We have roof. We have posterior wall and floor of inguinal canal. Floor of inguinal canal. So thank you so much. This is all about inguinal canal.